Step so that you can see him.
I know I'm in good hands. You do whatever you think's best.
So this is the, and it's really easy. I can go right through. Do you want to start with waltz or foxtrot?
Oh, so waltz is right there.
Okay. And so this has the list of each step. And just so you can see how this app works, it also has the breakdown syllabus and the videos and everything right there. Box step obviously is the first one.
Is this for anybody?
This is for anybody. This, the app for instructors and examiners, it's cheaper for students. Some of my students do have it, and it's like, yeah. I want to say like $17 a month.
Okay. Okay,
So
you can use it until you're tired of using it, or
yeah. And instead of buying each, and it has bronze, silver, gold, American style, smooth rhythm, international, Latin, and standard, everything on there. So you have access to all that. You can see the written syllabus. You can see, like if you go through, like on the box step right here, it has the first little box has the different things like the figure, the foot positions, timing, lead and follow. You can put notes in it yourself if you want. Then the second one is the syllabus. Oh, it takes a minute with the Wi-Fi here.
Yeah.
But it'll show the man's part and the lady's part, all the footwork, all the timings, all the details about it. And then
just a little like footprints and stuff.
It doesn't show footprints, but it does show
or is it a video or is it a
that is just a written.
Okay.
And you know what? Maybe I'm not on their Wi-Fi here anymore. Maybe that's what it is. Yeah. Oh, darn. Maybe because I went off that page.
No, it should. If you've got
one second, let's see. Let me just see if I'm.
I could log in.
Let me see if I'm.
I have some problems with YouTube.
Let me just see if I'm.
YouTube keeps wanting me to sign up for their new service.
I had their Wi-Fi. Not connected. Oh, you know why? This is a different laptop. Let's see if it will. I mean, not a different laptop, different iPad. Let's see if it'll go to whatever that one was.
Yeah, unless it's locked.
You know what? It was on my other one, and they're not here either. Oh, well, okay, let me just go back to the app real quick. Oh, maybe it's not going to even let me back up to that. Oh, anyway, so it on the last, there was three different boxes. The first one had the different elements that you can click off that you've studied.
Yeah.
Second one is like written. It has everything like left foot goes forward, right foot, and it'll talk about technique, if there's sway or shape or leading and following.
Uh-huh.
And then the third box on there was videos, and it's broken down into the leader, the follower, technique, and... So you can go to just that section of the video. You don't have to watch like a whole video to try to find the little piece that you wanted.
Yeah. Okay.
So it's actually, if you have a Wi-Fi connection, it works really good.
Okay.
Although I think I can set it up on my. Oh well. Darn. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so the box step is the first one.
Okay.
And the box step in the beginning is just no rotation at all.
Yeah, nice waltz, so the slow.
One, two,
quick.
Three. One, two, three. Mm-hmm. And now I'm going to do this with your frame. I'm going to bring your arm a little bit more here. Do you see how our arm fits together more?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right there.
Okay, and this would still be heel,
one.
toe, heel.
Uh-huh.
And toe, heel.
Uh-huh. Heel, toe, heel. So when you step back with your right foot, make sure it's toe, heel.
Okay.
Heel, toe, heel.
Okay.
Heel, toe, heel. Toe. Oop, do that one more time.
Yeah.
Heel, toe, heel.
Oh, I thought it was toe, heel. Okay. I'm not sure what I'm thinking.
Heel, toe, heel.
Okay.
Heel, toe, heel. Toe, heel, toe, heel.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So that's with no turn.
Okay.
And then the next thing is the underarm turn. And that would be from when you step back on the second half of the basic. So that's one, two, three. I go under to here, side together. So you're just going to keep doing the box step? Okay. Is that one that you use, that
yeah.
turn? Okay. One, two, three, back, side together, forward, side together, back.
Right, okay.
Mm-hmm. So that is one without turn, so you're facing the same way right now. Up.
I do it to Jerry, I'm sure. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then usually on that one, it's nice, like you can stay facing the same way as the most basic way to do it, but it's also nice to come around to pick up the lady. And what I mean by that is when you do the first half of the box and send her under, so I just finished the box, yes, then come over here to meet her and pick her up. Yeah. One, two. Three, one, two, three, come around. Yeah. And that makes it easier for the lady too. It makes a nice smooth transition instead of her trying to get all the way back around to you here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, gonna do that one more time?
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like I was late before raising the hand.
When you started the lead of it?
Mm-hmm. So right about there?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, good.
All right.
Yeah, just as you're stepping back, so that gives the lady warning. Let's see if it came up here. Not that I need it, but I wanted you to see it. Oh, well. Yeah, I guess it's not going to work.
Okay.
Yeah. I forgot.
The spinning wheel of death, you know, it's, can you get up your hold up?
Yeah, right. Okay, and then balance steps, hesitations, where you're stepping, very useful for if you're traveling, once you do start traveling and you need to stay in one spot without completely stopping, and that is stepping forward and hesitating. Stepping back, and you can go to both sides. Very good for the Viennese waltz, too.
Okay.
So this is one, two, three, one, two, three. In fact, in the new syllabus, this is actually the first step of Viennese waltz.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So we'll come back and talk about that, too.
Okay.
So you can do all four directions like we just did, or you can just do forward and back. So let's just say you need a little bit of time to hesitate, and then you can move off into something else, right? You can also just do, and this is especially good for Viennese waltz when you start, you can also just do the side to side.
Mm-hmm.
So you can just go side, two, three, side, two, three. And on this one, the hesitation in Viennese waltz or in slow waltz, regular waltz, you're stepping on the one and you're holding the two, three. So hesitation timing means, or, and this is also called the balance step. So hesitation timing and the balance step is really the same thing.
Okay.
So I'm taking a step and I'm balancing on this foot without changing weight or hesitating the rhythm of it. And then, so when I step back, I step one, two, three to the side, and side. Yeah, so you're only stepping on the first beat and then slowly drawing your feet together. And it is good to slowly draw your feet together as opposed to doing one, two, three, one, two, three. You can see then I'm just standing there too long. And when I get my feet together that quickly, it's easy to accidentally change weight. because here I'm not changing weight. I'm bringing that right foot in and not putting it down so that I can go back on it. Left foot, not putting it down so that I can move it to the side. So this is the one exception to weight changes, okay. Right?
That's my next question.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
And when you're leading this pattern, it's so that the lady knows that you're not going to change weight. It's really important to balance your head and your body over the standing foot. Sure. So if I did this, I guess I'll do it towards the camera so you can see it too. But if I did this and both feet are underneath me, it might be hard for the lady to tell which foot I'm standing on, and she might go ahead and change weight. But if I keep my balance over the foot that I'm holding my weight on, then she's going to feel that a little bit more. So if you're behind me, and actually just put your hand on my shoulder for a second. So when I do this one here, can you feel here I'm kind of even, here I'm holding my weight over this foot. And now when I step back, can you feel that I'm putting my weight, positioning my body over the standing foot? And when I step to the side, you can feel that my weight is more over that left foot and side. Because that's important for her to be able to understand what you want there, because that is the exception of changing weight when your feet come together.
Okay.
Another way that you can do it, and some people like to do this to stylize it more, is to not actually close the feet all the way together. So I would step forward, and you see how I actually make it like a point to the side, and a point to the side, and a point. And that you can sort of exaggerate that head over the standing foot, okay. Because the other foot's out to the side and like a balance point. So if you did that towards the mirror so you can see yourself. So here's the one where, let's just collect it right underneath us first. To here, and I feel like my head is a little bit over that right foot. Here, and here. Now with the point to the side, see, that really makes me, that makes it easy again for the lady to tell where my weight is. Mm-hmm. You want to do that one more time? So we're going forward, back, left, and right.
Okay.
So you have the choice of doing, closing the feet all the way or styling it with more of a pointing action.
Okay.
Okay, so you want to do that together?
Sure.
So I'm going to pull this elbow. Yeah, there you go. And relax that just a little bit. That's it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So that's easy for me to tell because I could definitely feel you putting your body alignment over the foot that you're standing on. So that definitely tells the lady which foot you're on.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So let's do, I'm going to put some music on and we're going to just do a waltz. And so we're just doing the box step.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I know. The next thing I wanted to do before I do that is we did the box step without turning.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to do the box step with quarter turn.
Okay.
So without turning, we stayed facing the same direction. Which is actually almost a little bit harder because it doesn't continue the flow of the movement. A quarter turn, you would turn, you would step forward, turn to face the wall, next wall, and so each quarter, each half of the box, you see a different wall. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And what I think about doing the man's part on that is as I step forward, I'm not really trying to turn to face that wall right away. But the turn, most of the rotation comes between the first and second step here. So I go forward and then turning to the side. And you can see how I got a little bit of like a swing out with that leg to help me rotate into it. Yeah, As opposed to the tendency in the beginning is to want to turn it early and it keeps everything really small. But this allows me to turn and swing. Yes, nice. Now, so when you're on the forward part of the box, you get more swing because you're the person carrying the momentum and you're sort of on the outside of the rotation. Mm-hmm. So I get more swing here. And on the second half of the box, my partner's going to be the one that's going to be going forward and doing the swing. So I'm going to cut back a little bit and I'm going to turn my foot. If you can see how my toe already is pointing to the new wall and my body hasn't arrived there quite as quickly. So my body's sort of somewhere in between. But now when I close my feet, my body finishes the rotation. And that helps me turn my body a little bit slower so that I can manage my rotation the same speed as my partner. Because it's always going to be a little bit easier for the person backing up because they're on the inside of the turn. So when I go forward here, and this is a good rule and very important for the silver moves that you're doing to kind of grasp this when it's more basic. But whenever I'm going forward, we might have mentioned this, my feet rotate on the floor. So when I step forward, you'll see my foot is pointing down the line here. But once I take the step, you'll actually see my foot rotate to the new direction. So it's pointing this way, and now you see it turning. Yeah. Uh-huh. So my feet swivel on the floor when I'm the one going forward. When I'm the one going backwards, they don't swivel. Actually, I point my foot to the new direction, close it, and there's no swiveling of the feet. So that's an interesting thing that will hold true no matter what level you take your dancing to. Okay. That when you're on the outside of the turn, your feet swivel on the floor. When you're on the inside, you're placing your foot into the new direction instead of turning it into the new direction. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Yeah, so again, it's you'll see this left foot turn to here. Yep, and then close your feet. And now when you step back, go ahead and change weight there. When you step back with your right foot, I'm gonna step back and point my foot to kind of towards the clock right there. Again, you can see that my body is somewhere in between. It hasn't got all the way there yet, but it's gonna arrive there when my right foot arrives. And then I'll just start all over. I'll step forward, swivel through, step back with the right foot, point my toe to the next wall, and then my body gets there when my feet close. Yeah. So that's really important, in especially when you get to that silver level, all those passing moves that you understand how your feet work. Mm-hmm. But if you can get that in the bronze level, like some people kind of skip past that in the beginning, but it's really important to have good. There you go. Okay. Nice. And just relax just a little bit through there. That's it. So you're turning and I'm pointing. Now, kind of cut your step back a little bit. We want quite a bit of momentum here. So move, and then I swing past you.
Okay.
You swing, I swing. You swing, I swing.
Yeah, this is something that we do need work on because the swinging gets
and it's easier to work on it in the more basic patterns.
Yeah,
you know, so okay. Then when you're doing the passing moves and all the silver moves, then you already kind of have the feel of it, and because that makes it more difficult when you're passing your feet.
Okay.
So those rules will hold true, like I said, no matter what level you go into. Gold bar. It's the same.
Okay.
Inside and outside turns. So there's those basic concepts that'll continue all the way through.
Okay, good.
Okay, so now I'll put music. Are we ready to change into the next dance, or do you want to do just a little music?
We can do a little music.
Okay. There we go. So we have that box mm-hmm. without turn and turning, but balance steps and the underarm turn.
Okay. Balance the first time I did it.
I was felt like you were going to stop there, that's why.
I wasn't really thinking about what I was going to do, I was just trying to let it flow a little bit.
Let me just stop here. Mm-hmm. Just bring this arm down just a little bit. You see how it starts getting up
there?
Yeah.
Okay. Should be going the other way, right? Like that. Okay, and then she turns her head this way when I do this?
Usually I'm still going to keep my head to the left, yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Mm-hmm. So when you do... when you do the hesitation going forward, mm-hmm. so you're stopping that momentum, right? So you have to let me know to not move to the side like I would normally do. I'm going to lead you one time.
Okay.
Okay. So I'm going to just move towards you. So you're going to go back with your right foot. Mm-hmm. And you see how you feel me stop over that foot?
Mm-hmm.
Stop. 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 You feel me keep going. Stop. Now, so right before I stepped, even just before I stepped forward, I started to slow that down so that when I took that step forward, you could already feel.
Sense that something's changed.
Yeah. So if I step forward at the same, with the same feeling that I would normally do, mm-hmm. if I was going to, so you're going to go back this way, move. Do you feel me continue through mm-hmm. there? And you feel me keep moving through there?
Mm-hmm.
Now, you can tell something different was mm-hmm. coming up.
Yeah.
So that's how you have that, and it's not something that you could probably even see as much
right.
as that you could, it's just a very small indication mm-hmm. that things are changing.
Okay.
That you didn't feel my energy come through to tell you to keep moving. You felt something kind of contracting and slowing down, right? So if you were gonna, you get to be the man again. You get to be you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah.
Yeah. Nice. Okay. Yep. Yep. So it's very subtle, but it gives you a much better chance of the lady getting that signal than trying to stop her once you get to that foot, right? Because she's already ready to keep going because that's the pattern she's used to.
Okay.
Yeah, so you gave her just that little bit of an advance notice. I could tell just by how you settled into your step that you were slowing things down. It became calmer instead of a continuation of movement that I would normally feel.
Okay, now switching to foxtrot.
Yeah. Yep. Okay, so foxtrot, the basic step is the two walking steps forward, the slow, slow, quick, quick, right?
That's good.
That's the bronze, yeah. Yeah, so starting back at the bronze, it's just the slow, slow, quick, quick,
yeah,
right?
The silver would still be slow, what, slow?
Yeah, when you get to the second half of bronze, you get from the basic rhythm that we're using now, which is two slows and two quicks, to, you drop out one of the slows, and you go to slow, quick, quick, instead of slow, slow, quick, quick.
Okay,
and that becomes like box rhythm. So the first step in the foxtrot when I go into that rhythm is when I learn to add the box step in.
Okay.
So usually we learn the steps that go with the basic foxtrot rhythm, the slow, slow, quick, quick, which would be the basic, a left turn, which is one step forward and one step back, that gets us out of the corners, or if somebody gets in our way.
Okay.
Uh-huh. And promenade, which is two walks, slow, slow, quick, quick. Again, two walks inside together.
Okay.
We actually did the zigzag. I don't know if you remember that, but it was the basic going forward at an angle and then backing up at an angle. So that kept that same basic rhythm of slow, slow, quick, quick.
Okay.
And you can do that in line where you're stepping right towards me or on the outside partner position.
Mm-hmm.
So those are, and then there's a like a step that just kind of swings back and forth that keeps that same slow, slow, quick, quick rhythm. So usually though you kind of learn all the patterns that are in that rhythm in the beginning of foxtrot. So if you're dancing with somebody really basic in one of the mixers, that's usually what they're gonna learn first, right? So if they just starting out, they probably, you'd have a better opportunity of doing that with them because it's slower. You have two slows and two quicks instead of one slow and two quicks. Speeds everything up. And then we usually move into the box rhythm and then all the patterns that go off that. And once you get into the silver, you pretty much use that box rhythm. There's only like very little patterns that have slow, slow, quick, quick.
Okay, slow, quick, quick.
Mm-hmm. But so the patterns that we can do with slow, slow, quick, quick are the basic.
Mm-hmm.
So your two walks forward.
Mm-hmm.
Slow, slow, quick, quick. Mm-hmm. The turning one, which is one forward and one back inside together.
Oh, yeah.
Slow, slow, quick, quick. Mm-hmm. And the do that one more time, and that'll just turn us a little bit better direction. And one back and side together.
Okay.
Oop, one more time. So it was forward. Oops, so you started to do a box stepping.
Okay.
Forward and back.
And then side
together.
Forward,
back. There you go.
Side together. Okay.
Promenade, which goes off this way.
Mm-hmm.
And you do two walks in that direction.
Now there's a transition to promenade from.
From the basic?
Yeah, so if we're going on the basic, then it would be, what's it? One, slow, quick, quick, okay, and then slow, slow.
Uh-huh. Now, the reason that you did that transition to go that way is that would move you with traffic. So let's say this is your line of dance and everybody's dancing around this way, and you're doing the basic this way, and all of a sudden you just cut right across the floor in a promenade. That might not be appropriate because you could kind of run into people.
Right.
So what you did when you did your basic, and we did this, I think on our first lesson together, is that we rotated it So now we're still moving in the flow of traffic. Yeah. Now the other time it's really good to do a promenade is, let's say we came up here and we're coming up to the end of the floor. This is a really good time to do a promenade because it takes me across to the new side. So it's a great corner step too. So far we had the basic, the left turn, and the promenade, all two steps and side together, mm-hmm. just using those two steps in different directions.
Okay.
The side-to-side swinging steps where we go side, side, side together. Mm-hmm. It's still two steps and side together. It's slow, slow, quick, quick.
Okay.
And that's a good stationary pattern if you need to keep in one spot, like if somebody, you get in traffic where there's
right.
nowhere to go. So you can just keep this, and you could repeat it again, and it would eventually move down the floor a little bit, or I can also rotate it a little bit. So let's say I'm facing this direction after a promenade, you know, maybe I did this, and I'm facing this direction. My options could be a left turn to take me around, or I could do the swing step and turn it a little bit. So that's just, they're all useful for navigating around the floor.
Okay.
So that swing, where you swing back and forth is, there you go, that's good. Side, 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 close. And when you close your feet, you change weight so your left foot's ready to go again.
It is, okay.
Okay, so we have the basic, we have the left turn, the promenade, and the swing step.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then the other one was the zigzag. And I know we went through these all in, I think, our first lesson together.
We were doing this, I think, out of promenade. We came together and then we did one.
Uh-huh. So on this one, if I think about like a zigzag down the floor, and I'm headed at this diagonal across the floor, which is diagonal wall, and I'm gonna take my two steps this way, and then when I do my side together, I'm gonna turn and close my feet. So now I'm ready to back up at a diagonal. Walk, walk, side together, walk, and then turn back. Yeah, uh-huh. And there's two varieties of that one, and that first one is called inline, meaning that you're stepping straight towards me. The other one would be outside partner, where you're walking on the outside of my feet. So the first one we'll do is straight towards me.
Mm-hmm.
So you do just like the basic going forward, but rotate the side together, and then backing up and rotate.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that's in line, and that term just means that you're walking straight towards me.
Okay.
Outside partner means you're going to walk on the outside of my feet. So as we step this way.
Step the same way, though?
Yeah, and if you're facing this direction, and usually you'll be at this diagonal already,
mm-hmm.
instead of stepping straight forward, my foot is just going to go off to a diagonal. So instead of going straight forward in front, if I'm already at this angle, this would be, if I was in line, I would step straight here. If I was going to go outside partner, can you see how my foot moved
mm-hmm.
at a diagonal? And interesting enough, you really don't have to turn your body. And if you do, it's just barely. But in the
just
beginning...
Just to displace you from your...
Yes.
Okay.
In the beginning, the tendency is to want to do this, to rotate the body into that
mm-hmm.
position. But so if you're facing me here, if you step straight towards me with your left foot, that would be in line.
Mm-hmm.
If you kept your body in the same position but just took your foot that way, that would be outside partner. And now you step through there.
Okay.
That was loud. And then I step on the outside of your position.
Okay.
Yeah? So it's the same step, but our position is just different.
Okay.
So those are all in that same rhythm of the slow, slow, quick, quick. Let me put a foxtrot on real quick now. And that's all the basic bronze. And sometimes if you get into a more advanced class, you might kind of skip into a little bit more like silver or ending bronze kind of moves. And remember to do your side together before you start walking out that direction. So you did a good job of curving it, but you didn't finish the pattern.
I was kind of an angle, but I was trying to get into promenade.
Right. So do that one more time, and we'll angle your basic.
Okay.
And now turn to promenade. So after your side together.
Yeah.
So you didn't finish the side together before you did.
Yeah. I see what I was doing. Mm-hmm. Okay. So that's like the prep step for the promenade. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Oops, so go forward first. Yep, you sure did.
Awesome. Okay.
Yep. Go ahead and try the inline one more time.
Okay.
For me is a little bit just putting on the brakes because you started to get ahead of the music.
Okay.
So I was kind of slowing you down just a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good, that's good. And so I think then the outside partner step, again, the way I know you're going to do that is you actually step up that diagonal.
Right.
Without really rotating your body, but just moving your foot that way.
So I could do that out of promenade.
Mm-hmm. And even in the promenade, instead of...
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm going to try to just go that way. Yeah. Nice.
And
so
right,
that's really...
Right peeling, yeah.
And slow it down a little bit. Quick, quick. Slow, slow. Whoop. Or a different feet there.
Yeah. Outside, go slow, slow, and you turn quick, quick. Now
yep.
From here,
now,
am I going straight back? I mean,
so you're
going
to go back with this foot first, your left foot?
Okay.
Yeah. And see if you could do that without, like, losing your frame here.
Okay.
So you turn into your arm. So when you go forward on that again,
mm-hmm.
So keeping this open still, so left foot forward. Yeah, there you go. Now you but now I would say so instead of can you see the difference in your shoulder? So if you overturn
yeah.
You, this all crunches up right there?
Yeah.
All of came just in time. You
Nice. So your feet really turn more than your body. Slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick. And now I would say just a little bit, you're wanting to turn that way too much.
Okay.
Yeah? Uh-huh. Now, if I hold your arms here, your feet can turn that way. You can see without.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you're this way.
Okay.
And back with your left foot. Oop, side together. Do that one more time, the forward part. Continuing to keep that relationship with the music, because when you have so many details that you're thinking about, it's easy to tune that out.
Yeah.
Right? And not, like, I noticed when you're not moving and just listening to the music, you can count out the beat. Uh-huh. But when you're focused on all these different positions and where your feet are going and where your partner is.
Yeah, I'm just hoping something else will pick that.
Yeah.
So.
Where that actually needs a little bit more focus, because. Uh-huh. That's a main, like, it's kind of the language that we speak. It puts a rhythm to our movement so that we can do that together.
Right.
So if I'm listening to the music and staying with the music, and you're listening to the music and staying with the music, that connects us both to that same element.
Okay.
Where if I could connect to your movement, but your movement, speeds up, slows down, it kind of changes a lot.
Right.
I could still kind of tune out the music and just go with you.
Right.
But it's much better if we're both, you know, because it really, that's what dancing is, moving in time with the music. Mm-hmm. If we understand how that works, it makes it much easier for us to synchronize our movement with the music. So, but it is really easy to tune that out when you really have a lot of things to think about.
Slow, slow, quick, quick, and the other one's the slow, quick, quick.
Yes.
So that would be the
slow, quick, 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 slow, quick, quick. Yeah. Yep. And that goes into box rhythm. You can do that as a closed box like we did in the waltz, or the open box where you pass your feet like we've done when you've done the silver movements that you showed me that you learned.
Okay. And then the waltz, slow, slow, quick, quick.
And the waltz is the 1, 2, 3. One,
is it
two.
1, 2, 3, or is it 1, 2, 3? Is it?
It's all equal.
It's equal count.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So waltz just 1, 2, 3. Mm-hmm.
So we don't count that in Fox. Slows and quicks.
Okay.
If we did, it would be like a quick is one beat of the music and a slow is two. If we said slows and quicks, it would be like saying quick, 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 quick. We don't, and it's, so it's much easier to just say the numbers.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay. And then slow, quick, quick, or slow, quick, quick, quick.
So slow, slow, quick, quick. Two slows, two quicks is the more basic rhythm.
Right. And then the more advanced is slow, quick, quick,
quick. Yeah. So you just drop out one of the slows. So instead of slow, slow, quick, quick, it's slow, quick, quick.
And then that changes to alternating foot pattern.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that's where it starts to become more like the waltz, right?
Yeah. And that's where it becomes confusing on the dance floor.
Yes.
I'm doing one or the other,
yeah.
or I'll be
yeah.
in the middle of a step, and as I come out, maybe it's more comfortable to transition to the previous one, so, okay, good.
Yeah, and then Venus waltz is the 1-2-3 pattern, just like the slow waltz, but mm-hmm. obviously much quicker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I should get slow Venus music.
Yeah, right, right. Yeah, so do you want to just do real quick, I know we're kind of right at the end, just go through that one basic Viennese pattern with the crossbody lead, underarm
yeah.
turn. Mm-hmm. You want to just do that kind of going down the, and we'll end it with that?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so.
1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1
Yeah, it's...
And you were able to get all the way around, you said, doing that, huh?
Yeah. I think we got all... We did a couple times where we kept having to stop. We got all the way around. So I feel like I know where I'm trying to go.
Yeah, that's getting much better.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, good job.